What's going on, everybody? Dato Doya here with another Dragon Ball FighterZ theme video. This time covering the reveal of Android 21 as a playable character in Dragon Ball FighterZ. While I expected her to be playable since they revealed her, it's good to finally get some confirmation that she'll be in the game, and that she'll be playable in her final form. And speaking of her form, we should probably cover that before we jump into the reading. As you can see, her design has changed from the simple scientist that she was before. Now she has a tail resembling Frieza, and the overall look of a female Majin character. A lot of people are claiming that this design change came out of nowhere, but I would have to disagree and say that this has been alluded to for a long time now. As soon as we received our first details about the Dragon Ball FighterZ story involving the characters losing their energy to some mysterious force, it was obvious that something was absorbing or taking their energy in some way. And you might remember a French trailer for Dragon Ball FighterZ that showed a mysterious female Majin character. Now, it was very hard to see by just watching the footage, but if you go frame by frame, you can make out the overall structure of what looks to be Android 21 in her final form. Couple that with the fact with every promotional video of Android 21 showing her crave power almost as if it's some sort of food, I figured she would serve as the Dragon Ball FighterZ version of a Cell and Android combined, on the hunt to combine every warrior's best traits so that she could become the ultimate life form. This goes hand in hand as to why she has a Frieza tail and also looks like a Majin. The tail is a good trait because it allows her to hit people even if her hands are preoccupied, and the Majin form allows her to be much more durable. Think of how hard it was to kill Majin Buu in the show. I don't want to say for sure, but my guess for the story mode would be that she combines the Majin's durability, and combines it with the Saiyan's boost of power they get when they're nearly defeated, and abuses that to get insanely strong. With that out of the way, let's jump right into the traits about Android 21, and what makes her unique as a playable character. Special thanks goes to Shonen Games for translating this page so soon. It says here, normally she is in her lab coat, but when the battle is on, she transforms to go all out. And I think these two pictures here depict her introduction when she's starting the battle. We can also see that she has an energy ball-like super, similar to that of Beerus or Frieza. So maybe running all three of these could make for an interesting-looking DHC combo. The similarities between her and other fighters in the game don't stop there, however. In fact, one of her main gimmicks is that she can copy a move from any character in the game, should she be able to land one of her moves on them. That move being Taste and Cut, as seen in this picture of Android 21 performing Krillin's Solar Flare move, and underneath it stating, absorb Krillin's energy to use Solar Flare. Knowing your opponent's strengths and weaknesses takes on a new level with Android 21. Android 21's level 3 is a super called Hungry Time, in which she turns them into a food, much like Majin Buu's Candy Bean. Seen here, you can see Android 21 turning 16 into a macaroon, but who knows what she could turn the other fighters into. Maybe she just prefers macaroons. But that's about all the information we're gonna get out of these scans as far as what she's able to do as a character. Personally speaking, I'm excited to see what people can come up with. A character that gets different special moves depending on who she absorbs always makes for a character that has a ton of interesting and unique combos. So I'm really excited to see what some lab beasts do when they get some time with her. But what are your thoughts on Android 21? Do you like the new design or hate it? Do you feel that it came out of nowhere or was it justified? Let me know in the comments below, and as always, I'll be down there. And while you're down there, if you like the video and the channel, make sure to click the like button and subscribe. I'm Dato Doya, and I'll see you in the next one.